We are my family church, Unity Temple, right here in our heartbeat of Brooklyn. This sanctuary is literally my foundation to all things music. Spending hours on hours between a Tuesday, a Wednesday, or a Friday, or Saturday for rehearsals, all day Sunday. It all started here for me. You know, this is home.
When he was a kid, his mom couldn't keep him out of the cabinets, getting the pots and pans to beat the drums. So he's been, you know, musically inclined from the time he was born, really.
His mother put a suit on him and a tie and sit him up there with the musicians. You never see nobody more happy than him, 3 years old and not looking at no keys, looking around to see if he excited everybody.
Like, I was always on the organ. Like, I was never almost nowhere else.
Took him to a prestigious school in Harlem. And after 2 weeks, she took him out of the school. And I said, what happened? She said, he's not learning, he's teaching. I said, what do you mean he's not learning, he's teaching? She said, he is showing them five-finger chords with his little fingers that they can't do.
Got a lot to be thankful for. Yeah. We made it a whole nother year. Yeah. I said, we made it a whole nother year.
He lost his mother at 7, then his father at 14. It's a difficult period for him. You give him the space to find himself, and you pray, continue to pray, that God keeps him on the straight and narrow.
I feel like at my lowest points in my life, I was always able to turn to God and feel God, feel a presence of God.
There's a different view on my up than it is on my down. But don't you turn your nose at me on my down. Because as sure as I'm going down, I'm getting ready to go back up.
I call it a record church. You know, it's like if you, you know, saw me here, you feel like, you know, you're in a church service. And this record is bringing me back to my childhood in ways that I've been longing for a very long time. And I wanted to make a record that people can understand where I come from and how that affected me as a musician. And I hope that when people hear it, they feel the spirit.
That's home. You don't never forget about home. That's like a reboot, a recharge. What raised you and what made you, like foundation.
I used to come here as a kid and watch so many amazing groups and choirs perform and so many amazing musicians perform. Butch Haywood and Melvin Crispell and James Hall and one of the greatest choirs, the Institutional Radio Choir. And I'm glad that it's still here because it's monumental to Brooklyn and to me as a musician who have come up in the church. It's the old hood, so it's good to see the old hood. This is like a tribute for sure. Every Sunday, we would sing these collection of songs. I invited my grandmama up to sing a song.
Come on, make some noise for my grandmama.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah. That's his girl. Cory will always, always, always love his grandmama.
She's literally like my best friend, you know what I'm saying?
Make some noise, make some noise.
This mother loved to see the reaction of people's face, seeing her son play the organ and, you know, and make people happy and excited. So she's looking down from heaven and she's grateful and that God blessed him with such a gift.
It's like, that's Cory Alexander Henry Buster. Yes, do it.